Welcome to IT Solution. In this video, I will show you how to design a login form with database. In my previous video, I have showed how to design a login form using simple else if command without a database. I have written code in the login click event button and application.exit in the exit button. I will make this password textbox password character star. Now I will design a simple database of user. I have already written the database script to make this video short. Start SQL Server. I am using SQL authentication, giving the password. Here I have created a database by the name LoginDB. Use the database LoginDB. In this database, I have a table tblUser with user ID, username, user password column. Create the table. Insert data. Show the data. Here I have three user data: ABCD, XYZ, hello, password 123456, 123456. Now I will go to the Visual Studio. I will add the connection on the database dot SQL authentication SA, giving the password, select LoginDB, test succeeded. Copy the connection string. Change the password. I will write edu.net code here. SQL command cmd equals to new SQL command. To add username and password equals to password. Comma connection object. CMD dot parameter dot add value. Txt username dot text. I will create two parameter. TxtPassword.txt. Here I have created parameter to avoid the SQL injection. I will create SQL data adapter object SQL data adapter TI is to new SQL data adapter passing the CMD command data table DT is to new TI dot dt.row.count>0. Message box dot show login success full. Is dot height reference one dot show else login failed, please enter valid user name and password. Entering a wrong password, login failed, login failed, login failed. Now I will put the right username and password, suppose ABCD123. Login successful. Here the new form or the landing form opened. I will give another password or username to check hello 123456. Login successful. You can do this by the count function also. Count star let's run the form. XYZ password 123. Login successful. See, the form is opening. So you can do this using either count function or select star. Select all the data from the database. So that's it for today. Thank you for watching this video. If you think this video will be helpful, do likes, comments and subscribe to my channel IT Solution. Thank you.